Senator Dolley, you are now a candidate for governor here in California. You've been in public service for quite some time. I want to ask you, was there a specific moment where you said, you know what, it's time for me to jump in this race?
Well, Nikki, as you know, that we've had 25 years of one-party rule in California, and we've seen the decline of our state. People are fleeing our state for the first time in the history. We actually lost population. So, my family's been here a long time. I've been elected. I love California. And so I've been pushing back for 25 years. I've been working, trying to make California a better place. And so this, I just can't take it anymore. And I wanted to make sure that my future for my children and my neighbors is why I got into politics. And so I jumped in the ring. This is definitely a David versus a Goliath. The governor has $25 million in the bank, and we're going to have a battle here. But I think that it's time in California. It doesn't matter if you're a Republican or Democrat or independent. The cost of living is high. We have seen crime. We've seen our education system not working well. And so I think there needs to be balance. That's what this is about. It's about balance. And so I think it's right for California. And I believe I can take him out because I'm the common sense. I run a business, hardworking, normal Californian that wants to see a better future.
Your announcement did surprise even some members in your own party. We have Leader Wilk on the show this week, and he said he did not know you were going to jump in the race. So did the state party reach out to you and encourage you to run?
You know, Nikki, actually, I did it all on my own. It was I didn't tell anybody that I was going to run because I didn't, people try to talk you out of things, and it's in my heart. It's been in my heart for some time to make a difference. And I want to tell our story, the story that doesn't get told much. I'm a small business owner. And I want a future for my family, and I want a future for the families around. And what we've seen in California is this top-down, total control, and it's running people out of the state. And so I could not stand by and watch the future of my children's, the next generations, get destroyed. And so I didn't tell anybody, and I announced, and we're rolling.
All right, so you mentioned the feat that is ahead of you. You are a Republican. You use the hashtag on Twitter. You even mentioned it here, David and Goliath. The governor, he's been criticized, but he still is pretty popular in the state of California, actually more popular than President Biden, according to a recent PPIC poll. So what are you going to do in order to get your message out there? Because, you're relatively unknown, and to win elections, you need name ID and you need money.
So my strategy is to find 200,000 people in California that want to stay here and want to get in this fight and give me a dollar a day. So you can go to briandolley.com to sign up. $1 a day, 200,000 people. I get the resources enough to get my message out across the state and share with people who I am and my ideas and why I care about California and stop the craziness of, one party rule.
All right. So what are going to be your specific issues? What are you going to run on?
Well, obviously, cost of living is impacting all walks of life. So I want to help lower the cost of living, which it would help. And then crime is number one. You cannot. What should government do? Government should do a few things. Public safety. We should do infrastructure. And we should do education. So those are all things I'll be looking at. I mean, obviously, education is huge. I'm really disappointed in our governor right now. He's at SoFi Stadium. He didn't wear a mask, and my daughter is playing basketball with a mask on, and we need to take the mask off our children. It's not right. It's doing a lot of damage mentally and socially. It's just the wrong approach, and you can't confuse your messages out, and that's what he's been doing because he's not telling the truth to Californians, and it quite frankly has all the control. We've pushed many bills through the legislature trying to get back the control in the legislature, and the Democrat Party has blocked all those bills.
Right, so you're a Republican, which means you're sort of persona non grata in a lot of ways. So let's just have a frank conversation here. You're gonna be going into these different cities and campaigning, and you're gonna get questions as a Republican. So let's just tick through some of the things that you're gonna be asked to be on the record for. We are a statewide show, we're inside California politics, so you can set the record right here. You have supported President Trump in the past. If President Trump is the nominee in the next election, would you support him?
Look, I'm a Republican. I'm going to be supporting Republicans no matter who it is. And it's a good question. I think it's really great. I've been asked this question probably the most of any, out of all the interviews I've been doing about Donald Trump. And, you know, Gavin Newsom wants to talk about Donald Trump because he doesn't want to talk about his own record. He has a horrible record. We had $22 billion stole from Californians in the EDD process. We have, he spent $12 million on renting the stadium, the Kings or the Sleep Train Arena, and nine patients went there. So he doesn't want to talk about his record. He wants to talk about somebody else. And quite frankly, if you want to say that he's got a better approval rating than Joe Biden, that's a pretty large low bar. So I'm excited to run against this guy. He's definitely going to try to spin it and talk about things he doesn't want to talk about because he doesn't want to talk about his record. And I'd be happy to talk about my record and my 25 years of being a public servant. It's an awesome record, and I'll defend it all the way. He doesn't want to talk about his weak policies.
Because his campaign is already circulating a picture of you and the former president. So, you know, we had to go there. Another big issue, vaccines. The Republican candidates in the recall got to ask you, are you vaccinated?
I am not vaccinated. I've consulted with my doctor. I believe the vaccination issue is between you and your doctor. I had COVID, had the antibodies, and so I have actually a better immune than the vaccine can give me. So I believe it's between you and your doctor.
All right, let's talk about climate. You obviously represent an area that was affected by the Caldor fire. We spoke about that on this show. So in terms of, you know, the way voters feel, do you believe that climate has played a role and that climate change is real?
Oh, absolutely. But just believing in it isn't the solution. What is the solution is doing the right thing. We don't, in California, I ran a bill last year to count the carbon that we emit during forest fires, and the Democrat Party blocked that bill. And why do they do that? Because we should count all carbon that we're emitting. It's because they want to regulate your lawnmower, your weed eater, and your generator that we desperately need because the power outages we have in California, and they don't want to do that. So I'm all about the environment. I'm a farmer. Look, I know you have to take care of the land and the environment, and I'm more of an environmentalist than most Democrats. They talk about it, but they spend the money in the wrong way. We spent $480 million this year on the bullet train. We haven't laid 1 foot of track. I think we should be spending that on our forest, making sure our forests are thin and taken care of in the right way, which impacts our watersheds and our wildlife. So I'm more of an environmentalist. I work in the dirt every day on my farm, and I know what the, because I'm close to the land.
All right, so let's say you are elected governor. You would have to work with Democrats. Who would be the first person in the legislature you would call?
Well, there's many good Democrats I work with. I've had 127 actually Democrats out to my district educating them. So I have a lot of friends across the aisle, and I believe there'll be some that vote for me. They don't like the governor. Inside the Capitol, they don't like the governor. And so I have a lot of friends. I'm not sure who it'll be first, but we'll cross that bridge when I win.
State Senator Brian Dahle, Republican candidate for California governor. We appreciate your time here on Inside California Politics.
Thank you. Go to briandahle.com.